This is Dr. Jason West, and we're going to talk about folic acid. Is it healthy for you? How much do you need? What can be the complications associated with it? It's really important for your nerve health and also for your detox mechanisms. A lot of great information in the video. Here it is. Hello, everyone. This is Dr. West. We're going to talk about folic acid. Is it safe for your body? What is folic acid? Is it part of the B vitamin family? And how does folic acid help you to be healthy? And after watching the value, you'll understand why folic acid is essential, how to get folic acid from your diet, and the incredible benefits of folic acid. Now, I counted about 9 incredible benefits of folic acid. Folic acid is part of the B complex vitamins. It's vital for red blood cells and for many other cells in the body. The form of folic acid occurs naturally in foods is called folate. And the functions of folic acid, along with vitamin B12, is important for the formation of red blood cells. A lack of these two vital nutrients leads to a variety of anemia called macrocytic anemia. This means that the red blood cells appear bloated and they're too large. They have a reduced capacity to carry oxygen. It's a really frequent cause of feeling fatigued and wore out and not having enough energy. And folate, along with other B vitamins, are vital for nerve function. Folate is essential for the formation of DNA within everybody's cell, and this allows the normal replication of cells. Folate acts as chemicals that medicate one carbon transfer reactions. These are important for the formation of amino acids of purines and pyrimidines, and these purines and pyrimidines are the basic building blocks of DNA or protein. Now, most of the requirements for folate in men and non-pregnant women are obtained from a healthy and well-balanced diet. No surprise there. Pregnant and breastfeeding women and children during their growing years require folate in their diet. And in pregnant women, for example, a lack of folate in diet can lead to severe nerve defects like a neural tube defect, spina bifida, encephalopathy and born children with cleft palates. So the daily recommendations for folic acid for adults and children over 11 years, it's about 200 micrograms. And any women considering pregnancy, 200 micrograms or more as a folate supplement is a really good baseline. Folate deficiency occurs primarily in two cases: the excessive demands of folate during pregnancy and breastfeeding, and the excessive loss of folate from like Crohn's disease or untreated celiac disease, alcoholism, the different types of medication side effects like a diuretic. And the symptoms of folate deficiency, in most cases, there may be a general symptoms of anemia like fatigue and tiredness, but there can be a factor in diarrhea, a loss of appetite, headaches, heart palpitations, sore tongue, and behavioral disorders. A folate deficiency during pregnancy can be associated with nerve defects in the fetus, and the fetus develops rapidly and develops spine and nerve cells in the first few weeks of pregnancy. Inadequate blood levels of folate during this time increases the risk on the baby's spine and developing a neural tube defect. This may cause something called a spinal malformation called spina bifida, and folates also help to reduce high levels of homocysteine, and homocysteine is a protein that irritates blood vessels. It's really important in managing inflammation, and this can lead to increased risk of heart attack or stroke. Now, there are foods that are rich in folic acid. It's naturally found in dark green leafy vegetables. The word folate, in fact, actually comes from the word foliage. Folate is a water-soluble vitamin, and it is thus lost easily from vegetables during cooking. This can be prevented by avoiding overcooking, and folates can also be preserved by steaming or not microwaving vegetables rather than boiling them. I don't think microwaving vegetables is the best way to prepare them. Folates are also present in foods that are fortified with folic acid. And this is practiced in many countries since, despite recommendations, many women do not take folic acid supplementations in early pregnancy. Foods commonly fortified with folic acids in are breakfast cereals and flour. Now, we talked about foods that have fortified folate, but routine fortifications may not be as beneficial as folates need to be supplemented along with other B vitamins like vitamin B12, because if it's not administered, it can lead to irreversible nerve damage. And there's a whole segment of your health associated with an MTHFR deficiency, and we'll talk about that in future videos. But if you can't use folate properly, you're not going to be healthy. Now, the elderly populations have a high risk because they don't get enough uptake of vitamin B12, and it's usually not present in their diet. And so those over 50 are advised not to take folic acid supplements more than 200 micrograms per day. But for others, long-term intake of folic acid and maybe from fortified foods and supplements, should be below about 1 milligram per day for adults and lower amounts for children. Folic acid was one of those very important things for health, but you need to make sure that it's balanced with other B vitamins. Too much is bad, too little is bad. We just finished the video on folic acid. It's part of the B vitamin family. We want to give you information so that you can achieve and maintain optimal health. If you perceive value, make sure that you like us. Remember, we're across all platforms. We're always doing podcasts, we're doing articles, and we're doing videos. We'll see you tomorrow.